So what do you think that women or the issues that women would raise more than men in peacekeeping and security?
Definitely is their own security, their own space to live, their own sustained livelihood. The first thing will concern the women is a ceasefire. They want to see that they can see their girls going and fetch the water from the well and they are secured and protected. They want to see that if they are going themselves to collect the wood for cooking, they are safe and they are not raped and they are not killed and they are not humiliated and their dignity is preserved. Those are the major things which women they can see. And of course, every mother would like to see her child in a better advanced stage with education, with good health, with advancement in his career and so on. So I wouldn't see a woman who would like to see her son carrying the arms and then going for killing himself or killing somebody else. The men, when they discuss, they will discuss the other issues. They attack us. We have to get a revenge. We cannot allow them to attack the village. We have to secure our own village. But the securing of the village is only by bullets. So the language of negotiation is only bullets by bullets or wealth creation or advancement in power. But women will look into the first thing is how to secure a village, how to secure a family, how to secure a community. And of course, if we start from a community, we can always get the conflicts reduced and then we get the peace established. So peace builders should involve women. If you have a police woman, definitely the first thing she will look into her own colleagues, how they behave, what their behavior against their own families and people in the displaced areas or camps. If you look into a military woman, she will not shoot before she is sure for what she is shooting. And it's not this collateral damages, which is becoming a very known norms and slangs for any damage which humiliate human beings. You know, a lot of women are advancing in bringing people together, and bridging cultural gap, and building bridges to other nations, and talking to rebels group, like in Syria. Women are going there and coming, talking to the rebels and coming back and talking to the governments. So women can be really bridges because those are their own sons and husbands and families and cousins. From my experience, Sudanese women have done quite a lot, really. You know, this is the first country which had established about 25% of the seats in parliament were secure for women. Why is that? Because I heard one of the lecturers who are talking about voting has nothing to do with the peace and security. That's not true. Seats in parliament secure for you to be in decision-making process. By that, when governments are discussing, they are part of it. They can put their opinion forward. They can reduce the high gear of process for attacking others. They can really come up with tactics, but harmful tactics, not necessarily always the wallets. And that is the first thing. The second thing, definitely community community-based activities. If women are involved, they can immediately realize the early indicators for warning, early warning indicators. They can act accordingly. They can get the community together. They can protect the children. They can help in moving people from one place to another. The third thing, which is very important for me, they can bring elements in the negotiation table, which is very much not looked at by other people.